There isn't much more enjoyable to a Nintendo fan than a major surprise reveal. These often happen in direct presentations, or like we saw recently with the Paper Mario announcement, can just be randomly dropped out of nowhere. But regardless of how they do it, making a new game reveal a surprise will create significantly more hype and excitement in the fanbase, which will in turn lead to more sales for that game. However, in the midst of the current world situation, many feel that Nintendo is going to be reducing the number of major surprise reveals this year, which will likely be the case, considering that many development teams cannot work at the same pace that they're usually working at. But there will still likely be some major surprise reveals this year, and I've compiled 10 big ones that I'll be talking about in this video. I'm not including reveals of new Super Smash Bros. Fighters in this list because we all know that there's going to be new fighter reveals throughout this year, and this same rule is going to apply for other downloadable content to games that we already know is coming, like Sword and Shield content for example. I don't want to waste time discussing reveals that we already know will be dropping. This list is mainly focused on unconfirmed rumors that have some credibility, and what common sense would dictate to likely be revealed this year. And with all that being said, let's get started. Before we start the list, I wanted to shout out the sponsor of this video, Raid Shadow Legends. Are you looking for a raw, dark, and epic RPG? Raid Shadow Legends will take you into the world of dark fantasy and realism. And the best part is it's free to play on both mobile and PC. Cross-device play is available as well. Playing the game recently, I got to the second stage of the Spider's Den. I knew this one was going to be tough, so I had to prepare for it while bringing some of my best champions with me for the fight. Kale, Luthia, Luria, Viscerator, and Sorceress were my choices for this time around. The team is a pretty even element distribution when all being used together. After a couple tries and getting my squad all leveled up, I finally went into battle, was able to come out on top, and reap the rewards. You can also challenge other players in the Raid community by participating in tournaments. You can be fighting the Spider's Den, Ice Golem's Peak, the Almighty Fire Knight, or the Notorious Dragon in order to win some awesome rewards and rare artifacts. And now in the new Raid update coming in May, you'll be able to compete in a brand new arena tournament. Earn points according to your tier and win awesome rewards in the local and global tournaments. By using my link in the description, every new player will get an exclusive welcome pack that contains 100,000 silver and a free epic champion, Jotun. You'll find your extra rewards up here in your inbox for the next 30 days only, so make sure you're quick so that you do not miss out. I think it's fitting to start off this list with some new mobile games. This one has a bit of confirmed information backing it up, but not quite enough to disqualify it from appearing on this list. You'll get what I mean here. Nintendo has confirmed to have some new mobile games coming. This is official information from statements that they've given to investors, but they previously said they weren't quite ready to reveal them just yet. If later in 2020 or 2021 is a potential release window for their next mobile game, which seems likely since they've had at least one release every year for the last four, then we should certainly believe that it's likely to get a reveal for one this year. In terms of what this could be, I think some sort of Zelda game would be really cool, and it certainly has to be coming eventually, right? Since it's one of Nintendo's biggest series, and for one reason or another, hasn't had a release on mobile yet. I don't really understand this, maybe they're just waiting to find out the perfect way to implement Zelda into mobile. I believe the top-down perspective for a Zelda game would certainly be the best route here. As I don't know how well a full 3D Zelda experience is going to work on mobile, I find the control scheme would probably be kind of difficult to implement with that. But from a top-down Zelda perspective, I could certainly see this game being a ton of fun to play through. There are always some difficulties that come with converting series that have established homes on one console over to another console, regardless of what the console is. But Nintendo's done a pretty good job on some of their mobile releases thus far, and I would really like to see a new Zelda, Splatoon, or some other Nintendo mobile game get revealed this year. The second new reveal that I wanted to talk about today is the reveal of the Retro 3D Mario Collection. This is a collection that I've touched on a lot in previous videos, but in case for some reason you're unaware, I'll briefly go over it here. There are many rumors going on right now that HD remasters of Super Mario 64, Super Mario Sunshine, and Super Mario Galaxy will be coming to the Switch in a collection this year, akin to the Super Mario All-Stars collections that have previously released. And this collection would just be fantastic to play through, not only for the nostalgia that all these games being put together will provide, but they'll allow new fans to be introduced to some of our favorite games from the past. There are obviously many changes that would be in order for these 3D Mario games coming over to the Nintendo Switch, such as the graphics, which is a big thing that has to be changed, particularly for the older titles like 64 and Sunshine. Control schemes are a little bit iffy for these games as well, and several other things that would need to be changed up, but going along with the many things that need to be changed, there are just as many things that we love about these games, significantly more even. And getting to experience them again this year, in a time where people really need something that they love and enjoy to latch onto, it would be a perfect fit. If you're interested in more of the changes I think need to be made to these 3D Mario remasters, I'll have a little playlist linked on the screen screen right now for videos all about that. The third big reveal I think Nintendo is going to give us this year is for Super Mario 3D World Deluxe. This is another game that was included in the same rumors, the 3D Mario Collection, as well as Paper Mario The Origami King. That game recently got revealed, so there's no doubt in my mind that we're going to be getting the other two big reveals as well. But Super Mario 3D World's re-release is going to be a little bit different than the Retro 3D Mario Collection, at least from what the reports are saying. While the 3D Mario Collection is going to be mainly focused on remastering and touching up the Mario games from the past, Super Mario 3D World, being a more recent entry in the 3D Mario series, doesn't have as many of those same changes that need to be made. Changes like graphics and control scheme doesn't need to be changed that much since the game is already made for a modern console, being the Wii U. Straight up porting it over to the Switch would make a lot of sense since they've already ported over a ton of Wii U games already. But it seems like this is going to be getting the deluxe treatment, and what I mean by that is there's going to be more levels added in. This is what the rumors have been saying. It's not just going to be Super Mario 3D World plopped onto the Nintendo Switch, it's going to be that game plus many more levels added in, and who knows how many they're going to end up including, but the level design of Super Mario 3D World is one of my favorite aspects about it. Sure, the levels included in 3D World were a lot shorter in length than the ones included in previous 3D Mario titles, but that doesn't necessarily have to mean it's a bad thing. It worked really well for the 2D Mario games to have shorter levels included in them, so for a 3D Mario game, it seemed like it would be a nice idea to try it out, and with 3D World, I think it worked out pretty well. I would certainly love to experience Super Mario 3D World again on the Nintendo Switch, and it would be a very exciting reveal for them to have this year. The fourth game that I wanted to talk about today is Pikmin 3 Deluxe. GamesBeat has said that along with the 3D Mario remasters, Super Mario 3D World Deluxe, and a new Paper Mario game, there is also going to be a deluxe version of Pikmin 3 hitting the Nintendo Switch this year. We don't have as much information regarding the Pikmin 3 Deluxe rumor as we do with the 3D Mario game rumors, but it is very interesting that this game is going to be coming as well. Interesting in the fact that this means that Pikmin 4 likely is going to be delayed even further. For those of you who are unaware, Shigeru Miyamoto said back in 2015 that Pikmin 4 was in development and almost done. And what's the calendar say? Oh, 2020? Yeah, 5 years later, this game is not only not released, but it's not been revealed. I predict this game had restarted development somewhere in its cycle, especially when the Nintendo Switch hardware was coming out. Maybe the developers were not as familiar with the hardware and then had some ideas for new gimmicks that would have to be changed for Pikmin 4 to specifically adapt to the Switch hardware. Man, I don't really know what's happened to Pikmin 4, but if this Pikmin 3 Deluxe rumor is true, I'm sure there's going to be a lot of Pikmin fans that are excited to experience this game again, but it's going to be nowhere near the amount of hype that they would have for a new Pikmin release. Unfortunately, that's not something that I could reliably put on this list since I'm trying to focus on games that are more likely to be revealed this year rather than just wishful predictions. And Pikmin 3 Deluxe, it certainly seems like because of these reports that it could be revealed this year. The fifth reveal that I could see happening this year is an expansion to the Nintendo Switch Online service. Recently, it's been published that there are over 80 games from the NES and SNES present in the Nintendo Switch Online service. However, even with this large amount of games, it's still severely lacking compared to the Virtual Console, and fans are expecting more, and have been expecting more for a long time. With continually decreasing numbers of games from these consoles available to include, it's inevitable that the next step will be to include games from other consoles like the N64 or Game Boy. And now would certainly be a good time to reveal that these games will be coming, since online gaming is likely what we're going to be focusing on until it's safe to play more locally. There's no better time than now to reveal an expansion of the Nintendo Switch Online service. And since they seem to be running out of big ticket titles from the NES and SNES to include, in combination with the fact that the fans are really craving more out of this service, it's all lining up to make sense for Nintendo to reveal an expansion to this service. One thing that I wonder about this is if Nintendo is going to consider adding paid tiers to Nintendo Switch Online. I think we'll have to focus more on this when games from consoles like the GameCube and the Wii and the DS end up getting included on this. If they end up getting included on this, then I believe most definitely some sort of tiered system for payment would have to be added in. But as of right now, even in its current state for the low price, the Nintendo Switch Online service is still very disappointing. We don't see many discounts for games on the store, which is something that Nintendo's competitors' consoles have been providing with theirs. So if the games are going to be the main draw here, we should at least expect games from more consoles than just the NES and SNES. There are some great legendary games here, but they don't have as much content as fans are expecting out of modern titles. If you're going to make people pay for something that at least provide them with enough content that they're satisfied with it. Reveal number 6 that I wanted to talk about today is a teaser trailer for Metroid Prime 4. We've known about this game for almost 3 years now, with a reveal in June of 2017 for E3. It was announced to have restarted development in 2019, but that announcement happened in January, and we're approaching around a year and a half since then. It was likely before January that the plans for restarting were actually put into place, and I get that these things take time, but you don't want the Metroid fanbase to get too frustrated with no news whatsoever on their most anticipated upcoming release. Even if this game isn't coming out until 2022, or maybe even later, although I really hope not, I think we still have a good chance to see a teaser this year. Kinda like the Bayonetta 3 teaser. With the original Metroid Prime 4 reveal, it was just shown as a logo, with now in development being put on the screen as well. But I think something like the Bayonetta 3 teaser, not really showing gameplay, but just a little something, just so that we could see Samus, maybe get a couple of hints dropped for what the game is going to be like. This itself would be a massive reveal to the fanbase, and one of the biggest pieces of news Nintendo could put out there without too much effort. Do you run the risk with this idea of people expecting Metroid Prime 4 to be released much sooner than it's actually going to be? Yes, but you also do accomplish a different goal, and one that I believe is a little bit more important. Satisfying the fanbase, giving them what they want, and letting them know, hey, we haven't forgotten about you. That game that you really want, it's still coming. It's still on the way. Now, we might as well keep talking about Metroid here, with reveal number 7 being a new 2D Metroid game. Sabi had previously reported on a new Paper Mario game coming out this year, which obviously was proven to be accurate with Paper Mario the Origami King. Sabi also stated that a new 2D Metroid was coming this year. This game releasing would certainly be a good holdover for fans of Metroid Prime 4, and I know development of this game may have gotten delayed, so we shouldn't be entirely expecting a new 2D Metroid to release this year. But if the game was planned to release this year, then a reveal this year isn't too outside of the box. I still think an announcement could realistically be expected for either a planned release timeframe or a delayed one, maybe sometime next year. It's been a long time since we got a brand new 2D Metroid game. Fans did get to experience this type of gameplay with Samus Returns, which is a large reimagining of an older 2D Metroid game, but still not an entirely new title, and this is really what fans want. While the main thing that most Metroid fans are looking forward to is Metroid Prime 4, this, as I mentioned, would be a great holdover. And in combination with the reveal of a Metroid Prime 4 teaser trailer, this game's announcement would be great. It would be universally loved with the Metroid fanbase, and there would be a lot of people talking about this game, going to buy it, showing their support for the series, and letting Nintendo know that all this work and effort that they're putting into Metroid Prime 4 is going to be worth it, because these fans are out there and they really want to buy this game. Reveal number 8 has to do with The Legend of Zelda, and this is a release date for Breath of the Wild 2 and some more gameplay being shown of it in combination with this. Nintendo showed a trailer for Breath of the Wild 2 last year at E3, and while it doesn't seem anymore like it's going to be coming out this year, I still think it's very likely to come out next year, either as the major holiday release or in the original spring time frame that Breath of the Wild had. Considering that they're using the same engine as the original Breath of the Wild, it shouldn't take nearly as long for development. But we are aware that there's a ton of effort and care being put into these games, so you never know. I still think though that it's very likely that we get some sort of a showcase for Breath of the Wild 2 this year though, with a release date being added in. I think it's highly unlikely that this game is going to be releasing after 2021, and obviously if it is, then we shouldn't be expecting a release date to be shown this year, but at least the time frame of holiday 2021, spring 2021, whatever they want to say, with a new gameplay trailer being added in, I think it's very likely for this year, just because there's a ton of Legend of Zelda fans that are wondering what's next for the series. In the midst of the current world situation, they don't really know too much about what's upcoming for their favorite series, and Breath of the Wild 2 is really the only thing that they have to look forward to, and the carrot is looming in front of them, but with no exact time frame of when they're going to get that carrot, things may be a little bit frustrating for them. The number 9 reveal that I wanted to talk about today is new Nintendo Switch hardware, like a Switch Pro. The idea of a new, more powerful version of the Nintendo Switch has been thrown around in the community for quite some time. Even when the Switch first released, many critics noted that the console's power was still lacking compared to competitors' consoles that released several years prior. However, Nintendo may still be planning to release an upgrade, as recent events are adding more fuel to the previously ignited fire, as the version 10.0 update to the Nintendo Switch added support for new hardware. Considering that this has been added, could this be hinting for a Nintendo Switch Pro? Maybe. Considering that this was included in an already released update, I doubt it would be unreasonable to think that a reveal for this could come as soon as this year, especially since it's mainly a specs upgrade rather than creating a brand new generation of Nintendo consoles. If this was an entirely brand new generation of Nintendo consoles, there would obviously be a lot more marketing and effort and care put into the reveal of this, but like they did with the Nintendo Switch Lite and it was kind of just randomly dropped, they could maybe do this for the Nintendo Switch Pro, maybe a little bit more since the specs are actually improving rather than downgrading this time around. We'll just have to wait and see, but I think there is a good chance that we get a reveal of that this year. And the final game that I wanted to talk about in this video, number 10 on the list, is Mario Kart 9. Another sobby rumor, which may not exactly be pointing to Mario Kart, but hey, this is a list of maybes and all we could really do is speculate at this point. Sabi had stated that a major holiday title for 2020 would, quote, have tires. Mario Kart is a major Nintendo series and obviously fits this criteria. When talking about major series that don't have a new iteration on the Switch yet, Mario Kart certainly fits the bill. There is so much potential for Mario Kart 9 to blow up sales-wise, considering that Mario Kart 8 Deluxe is the best-selling game on the Switch right now. You can only imagine how well a sequel would do when you're now adding in potential sales from people who already bought Mario Kart 8 on the Wii U and didn't want to double dip on the Nintendo Switch, despite the new content being added in. It seems unlikely that a game this major would actually release this year, but hey, part of the rumor was true, and even if this release gets delayed due to current conditions, this would still be a major 2021 release. Mario Kart 8 Deluxe is such a great game on its own, so I'm really curious to see how they even try to improve upon it with Mario Kart 9. Will it be with the character roster? Will it be with the track selection? Will it be with the online functionality, the gameplay itself? There is so many questions surrounding Mario Kart 9, and that's why I would be so excited for a potential reveal of it. If you're interested in more Nintendo content coming your way very soon, I'd consider subscribing and ticking the bell icon so that you do not miss the latest videos that I post. There are also links to videos that I've already posted right now on the screen. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you soon.